Assalamu alaikum to everybody.
Thank you, Colin sir, and thank you, Faisal, for sharing your time. Once we talk of conflict, we have to divide this conflict zone into two parts. One thing is that how will you provide legal aid in the conflict zone? Second is that the people who belong to the conflict zone but reside in non-conflict zone or do some work in non-conflict zone, how will you approach them? As far as the state of J&K is concerned, it has all along remained detached from the right system, from the law system, from the legal system, from whatever types of privileges the people elsewhere are having. The people of Jammu and Kashmir do not have those rights and all that. We have a law there, Armed Forces Special Powers Act. You can kill a person on the basis of suspicion. You can blast his house, and they do it. To eliminate one militant, they burn the colonies together. Then whosoever protests against that, they label them terrorists again. This is all happening in the state of J&K. As far as the providing of legal aid is concerned, I remember an incident in which one of my friends, he was a counsel to one of the accused persons who was charged under sedition law. He got a bail order in his favor, but since there was nobody to take that bail order to the police station, he himself went to the police station. After coming back from the police station, his whole clothes, they were gone. He was bleeding like anything. We reported the incident to the judge. He narrated his tale before the judge that once I demanded his release on the basis of that court order, he was there hanged upside down, that he was thrashed by the concerned police officer. This is the situation with a lawyer. You can well imagine what is happening with the ordinary people. There was a case in Shopian area. Two girls, one Asia and another Nilofer. They were sister-in-law. Asia was sister-in-law of Nilofer. They were firstly gang-raped by army. Then they were dumped in a stream. Whole Kashmir went against this incident. For 2 months, there was a total shutdown in whole of the Kashmir. CBI was appointed to cover up, rather not to solve the case, to cover up. CBI in its finding that they actually died after drowning in a stream. There is a stream known as Rambir Ara, and the water level in that stream at that very point of time, it was not more than 1.5 feet. So this CBI in its exclusive and very impressive investigation made us to believe, made whole of the India to believe that these Kashmiris are actually terrorists. They are actually there to malign the Indian army and all that. That's why these two persons who actually died in a half, 1.5 feet water, they drowned in that. They are labeling that these are this, they have been gang raped, and thereafter they have been dumped in that water. The fun is that the persons who were fighting their cases, the doctor who gave the evidence in favor of the persons that they were gang raped, he was charged. Charge sheet was presented against him for giving the false evidence, allegedly. The lawyers who represented the cases of Asia and Nilofer, they were charged under different sections of the IPC. And many people who supported that movement against that injustice, all were labeled as terrorists and all that. So this is the thing what happens in the conflict zone. Now coming to the another aspect of the matter. There are many people from Kashmir who may be in Rajasthan, maybe in Mumbai, maybe in Delhi, maybe in other parts of the country. They are branded, they are the sting ducks for the people. They are easy to be trapped and thereafter doubled as terrorists. There was one person, Farooq Ahmad Khan. He was picked up in 1996. I would like to share, in 1996 he was picked up. He was an engineer at that point of time. He was labeled as a militant. Thereafter, a trial against him began. He wrote a letter to his brother. This brother, I will be sharing it with you. He wrote, I am a human being in the world's so-called biggest democratic country. I am an engineering graduate and was government employee. I joined the services in 1991 as a junior engineer. Now, if you are thinking that at this point of time, I will be promoted and will be living a healthy life with my loved ones, then you are wrong. I am living the life of an unknown prisoner in the jails for the last 12 years. We all know that a life in prison means a maximum of 14 years, which I have almost completed. But you will be shocked that I have not crossed my under trial period yet. Hail democracy. But this is not one, two or three, while in hundreds. I have been accused of nothing. My Allah is witness. At the same time, I got a chance to neatly monitor the sufferings of Kashmiris lodged in different Indian jails. This injustice has made me understand that India neither has understood us nor will understand us. So the problem with the system is that once you are having a voice of dissent, the system doesn't want to understand you. And if anybody wants to understand you, then he is labeled as a co-user with that person. For God's sake, don't have these double standards. The people in India, if India is this democratic country, then the people in Kashmir are having the equal rights as you people in Mumbai are having, or for that matter, in any part of the India are having. Why these double standards? Why would you pick up a Kashmiri for the simple thing that he has allegedly supported the Pakistani cricket team? Why would you do that? I am a supporter of New Zealand team. Would you brand me as well? I don't support Pakistan team. I mean, this is purely supports thing. You cannot have these double standards. And once you adopt these double standards, instead of making a cohesion, instead of integrating the whole of the nation, you are actually disintegrating it. You are allowing the people to move away from you day by day. You are allowing the people to go from you. You are giving them a good reasons to say, we don't belong to you and you don't belong to us. Unless and until these double standards are not clear, whatever the legal aid we provide in a conflict zone, whatever sort of help we render to the people in a conflict zone, this is not going to help. We have to firstly clear our minds. We have to thereafter clear our hearts. I would wrap up this my talk with a couplet. Mera qatil bhi mera munsif hai, main kiske haath mein apna lohu talash karu. Thank you.